Welcome back. Today's goal will be to finish the remaining levels of Blitz Tactics and do so before it gets unbearably warm in here and I'm forced to turn on the AC. So there's a timed challenge in a sense, you know, other than this game having a timer. So let's get started. I see my queen is attacked. See, I could take a queen and then lose my queen and a rook. I could also just check and then take the queen, which is probably what you should do. I hesitate to call that a tactic, although it really is one. Alright, what's going on here? The queen is offsides. It's not trapped though, because if rook c1, queen a6. I've got knight b2 and queen a4, that doesn't win the knight. I've got bishop e2, which does not win the queen. There's a lot of moves that don't work. Okay, so what's the key idea in this position? Taking b7 seems reasonable, but this puzzle wants me to aim for something better. Well, this is interesting. Oh, right. So this is a fork, and then we just take the rook. Okay. Just take everything. Mate. More free stuff. Oh, do I have a mate here? Right, rook takes. Oh, is that I made a move on the move? I'm stumbling over my words, just given my surprise at what resources are in that position. Free queen. Can't object to a free queen. Okay, what's going on? What's the deal in this puzzle? I could take c5. I'm not sure. Oh, I could just mate over here. Free rook. Oh, wait, now I have to lure the king out. Unlike all these other puzzles where you've had to confine the king, in that case you had to lure him out. Oh, that's clever. Alright, and what here? It's not that check. It's not the obvious check. This wins a rook. And black is deciding to challenge white on that. Can't move that. I should just play rook takes. Check, 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 check and mate. There's not a mating net there. Or at least not with that move, huh? I could have sworn that knight h6 looked pretty strong. Either I'm just not warmed up, or these puzzles are legitimately harder than the ones we saw yesterday. Or both. Oh, right. So we do this, and just step over there, and knight takes. King takes, and then we mate. Nice. Alright. Queen d8's the key. Mate in two. Oops. Not mate in two. Not mate in two. Check. You know, at some point you think it would just give me credit and say, Dan, I think you found the solution. Well, that was fun. That was a silly little. I don't even know if you could call it a puzzle. So rook d2 doesn't work. Oh wow. That's an irregular mating pattern. Okay, so rook takes, check, 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 check and mate. Queen e8 mate. Rook a8, queen f7. Queen e6, it's a useful intermezzo. I'm not sure why king e7 is no good there. There's your mate in 3. There's queen d8 mate. There's drawing the king into the corner. It's free knight, free bishop, free. Whoops. Gotta take here, check. And then mate. Free rook. Although I suppose running away with the king instead of walking into the pin is no better. Not entirely obvious. Okay, and then we win the rook here. And then free rook. So much free stuff. Go out to a rook for laughs. Chase the king. This is a pretty silly king chase. And it's just too well structured. And we take that with check. Knight in 2. And we're on to level 57. So as indicated in the stream title, this is blitztactics.com. Also as indicated in the corner of the stream, unless something's wrong with my layout. Or I'm sorry, Blitz Tactics. It doesn't say .com, but that should be implied. Yeah, the basic idea is that you solve a set of puzzles, and once you get in the habit of solving them fast enough, get credit for the set of puzzles and you get to move on to the next set. Now they call each set a level. Okay, that's fine. They're well within their power to do that. I think it's a silly name, but sure. This win's a queen, so let's win the queen. I'm not sure that this instills good habits, by the way. Because you're kind of forced to guess on some of the puzzles, at least the first time around. Wait, is it rook e7? Right. Well, that was cool. Mate in 1. It's nice to have some alternation or variation from these mates in 1. Okay, why is it not rook b7? Was this better? This traps the king. Okay, check. I win a queen. Oh, I get it. Knight g6 is coming anyway. Okay, free queen. Okay, do I win the rook down here? Yeah. Win material, win material. Wait, is it not Queen H5? Okay, that's not just a mouse slip. There's something else going on here. Is it Queen G5? Threatening mate on G7 directly? Then he moves the bishop away and then we check on that. No? Oh. Do this with check. I think my queen g5 was good though. Oh, here's a check that doesn't lose a piece. Here's another check. Just do everything with check, the game says. Okay, where's this king going? Yeah, that works. Just support the pawn and then promote it. And you have a nice, simple queen versus rook checkmate, or end game. I say facetiously as I laugh. All right, so where are we going on? Yeah. I've played a lot of blitz chess and a lot of bullet chess, so I tend to be fast at coming up with these combinations. Any chess master or expert would also be fast at these. Particularly after you've solved it the first time. This one's tricky because this king is, it's in a weird space. Like, I feel like I'm supposed to do knight g5, and then knight takes all the things. I'm just not sure how to get to a point where I can play knight g5. Rook takes h5 looks wrong, because pawn takes, I check on g7, no I don't. Let's try it. Now knight g5, now knight takes something. Now is this mate? No. Oh, the knight's hanging. And just everything hangs. It's mate in one. Oh, mate in two. Okay. Some of these require you to be a little more cautious than previous levels. It's rook e7. That one's tricky. Free rook. Now, we saw this one before. We've seen. My mouse slipped. My bad. We've seen all these before. Oh, rook h4, mate in 3, mate in 1, mate in 1, mate in 1, mate in 2, bishop's guarding f8, trap the rook, protect the pawn, and push. Check. Get the king out here and mate. Free knight with check. Apparently, this is the way to go about this, just by process of elimination. Oh, this wins the knight, and wins the queen, and the king, and the game. So the reason black is away the queen is to stall the mate for one move. Not sure why he walks into that pin. Oh, right, because his king's trapped. Okay. So I'm good at coming up with candidate moves. And in cases where there's only a single candidate move, I just play it. So some of these puzzles, at least in my mind, don't challenge you to evaluate, because once you find there's a possible idea, and you find that that's the only possibility, that makes it just really easy to just play the move and see what happens. Because you know it's a puzzle, you know there is a solution. And if you find only one check or capture, or one quiet move that makes a devastating threat, then that's the move. Just by process of elimination. Or, I'm not sure. Process of elimination's too strong, maybe. Now, I didn't make the music on that site. I do have a work in progress, but I can't seem to figure out how to use the MIDI.js interface. Let me see what I can do about the volume. Let's see, my mic is maxed out. Let me just check, are there any settings I can change here, or maybe I just need to stop mumbling. Yeah, I don't think there's anything settings-wise I can change. I could move the mic. Yeah, let me mute it for a second, move it. All right. Hopefully that'll work better. If I haven't refreshed the scoreboard, let me do so now. And let's go on. Level 58. This is a pretty common tactic that wins the knight. The reason it wins the knight, I'm getting distracted by solving all this. The reason it wins the knight there is because you have a knight fork to follow it all up. Wait, what? What's going on here? I trap your king. Oh, king's already trapped. I just take your rook, which I'm attacking. Okay. Oh, I can save my bishop and win a rook. Why didn't you tell me? Let's pin the queen and then take the bishop. Check, check. This has got to be mate. This has got to be mate. This has got to be. There it is. Free queen. Oh, whoops. Kind of lucky coincidence, maybe. I guess I got enough pieces to justify it. I'm like, ah, free queen, how bad could this be? That's exactly what I'm talking about, where if you find something that looks remotely plausible, it's the move. There's too many tactics, sites, puzzles, problems, etc., that just rely on guesswork. And blitz tactics is no exception. Sometimes it's amusing. Oh, I saw this. I was just too lazy to, like, put the piece back and then try the other one. All right, so what's going on here? Oh, is this mate in one? No, it's not mate in one, but I mean, mate in two is good enough. Check. Ooh. Okay, I can't just take the rook on c8. Nope. Oh, I've seen this one before. My, it's been a while since I've seen actual non-obvious mating puzzles. This king is escaping. That's a problem. Okay, so. Yeah. What, knight e4 maybe? And then this mates? Because the queen covers f5. Free queen. Free queen. Mate, maybe? Yeah, well, that works. Check. This check, maybe? I don't see where any of this is going. Why is that best? Oh, okay, I get it. That was really subtle and nuanced. Free queen? Free king? There we go. Yeah, some of these, you can solve it without understanding why the defender does what he does. I don't think I especially care for that. That traps the king, and then we deliver the mate. The rook's trapped. We win the rook. Free queen. Okay, and this is a typical Sicilian tactic. Just free piece right in the opening there. Because black's a bit overextended, and there's too many loose pieces and such. Got a nice little ladder going on. Okay, it's this rook, which forces the mate in three. Pin the queen, and then mate. Then this check. And he blocks at the rook. Yeah, this is ridiculous. I'd be surprised if such a tactic were useful in an actual game setting. Okay. Oh, king's trapped. That's why he blocks at the rook. Okay. That was a bit nuanced. Free queen. There we go. Okay, so I win a knight. I block here, and I win an exchange, and then I have to trade my queen for the remaining rook. So it's not a total win, but white is winning material there. It's mate in two. I forget. Queen covers f5. Mate in two. Check. Check here. Win the rook. And except take the queen instead. And there we go. That was a good set. Like, if I could bookmark this particular set, this level 58, I would do so. But there's no way to, like, upvote it or something like that. Anyhow, let's update the scoreboard. I'm on to level 59. Mate? Wait, how does rook d4 and rook e8 not win, like, on the spot? How is there anything better than rook to d4? Oh, he's got rook d6. That's what's going on. Okay, so I'm supposed to just win the rook this way. It's not just a mate puzzle. Some of these puzzles have an objective other than checkmate. Free rooks. Okay. Took me a second to find that. Right. So you need to check like this. What's the follow-up? I mean, I know taking the knight's good, but I feel like there's got to be a mate here. I don't see a mate. If I just put my knight on e7, surely a mate follows quickly. Knight g6, knight f6, knight e7. Intending rook takes knight. Well, it's just too abstract. I need to take the knight. No? Is it knight g6? No, knight f5. There we go. That's actually a useful tactic that would probably show up in a real game. Like I was saying, some of these don't seem generally applicable. But oh, here we go. Nice deflection tactic. But yeah, that particular knight tactic, that mating theme is pretty relatively common just because players will miss it. Mate in two is better than whatever I was looking at there. Oh, come on. I seem to find the difficult way to do things before I find the easy way. Free rook. Oh, come on. If I promote the pawn, do you think that I see the idea? See, if I were able to trade queens on e7, I could just do knight takes c6. I think here I'm supposed to invert the move order, knight takes c6, and if queen takes knight, I just take b8. So that's cool. Queen is pinned to the back rank. Queen's again pinned to the back rank. Very cool. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Whoa, okay. A lot of stuff going on here. There we go. Deflection. Slate really likes those mates on the H file. Threaten mate. Alright, so I don't remember this one. Did I just take en passant and then let him take and just get ruined? Do I sack on g7 just for initiative? Okay. Yeah, free queen. Oh, do I keep taking with check? And check. I check you. I check you again. I check you a third time. All right, there we go. That was enough checks. It's funny how it demands the fastest checkmate, even in positions where no human's gonna care how fast it was. Oh, knight c3 is faster. Okay. Yeah, you're right. You're not wrong. 3, 4, 5, and 6. Another common mating pattern. Deflection. Alright, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Decoy. Lots of checks. A mating net. I wonder if I had something faster there. Free queen. Mating net. Another mating net. Another mating net. Apparently, it's so convincing that Black decides to give up his queen, although I'm not entirely sure why. But it must be convincing. Okay, deflection. Or overloaded piece. Mating net. Intermezzo. Mating net. Decoy. And there we go. I'm still curious about that one we looked at two puzzles ago there. There's something there I didn't quite understand. Like, why the defender played the moves he did. So it doesn't really make it easy for you to review things when you're done. But I remembered the right moves, so yay for me. Maybe next time I see the puzzle, as it'll probably crop up in a future level. Maybe I'll see it and appreciate it a little better. Whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What's going on? I've got a fork. Okay. That appears just like too common sense. Okay. Well, that was easy. Well, that's not winning the queen. Trap the queen. Okay, what's the deal here? Do I just win the rook? Interesting. I was just speculating on the moves, but apparently those were right. That mates. Okay, hunting the king somehow. Oh, the king is stuck on the back rank. So I just power my way through it. Okay. Rook B8. Whoops, that's not right. Rook D6. No. Rook D6 wins a queen for a rook. And then wins the rook and the bishop and the whole game, but apparently there's a forcing mate continuation. Where's the mate? Oh, queen A3. I saw rook A4, but I didn't see queen A3. Or I thought the bishop covered both of them. Should be pretty illogical. But who said chess had to be logical anyway? Okay, so we reduce his defenses and then go in for the checkmate. Rook takes H6 looks natural. Oh, there's nothing defending the knight. I hesitate to play Queen H7 because I don't see a follow-up. Okay, I see something that looks like a follow-up. Yeah, that's weird. Don't expect to see things like that in your own games. Mate. Mate. Trap the king. Queen H7 is mate. Or Queen F7. Oh, it's not mate. I wanted it to be. That would have been really convenient if it were. Okay, so I don't have a checkmate. I should just win the bishop. Free queen. Mate in six. Or seven. That's mate in one. Oh, it's not mate. Huh. There it is, Bishop F1. Would you look at that? Oh, hang on. Right, so you force him to move the pawn to D6, and then you go to F7 mate. Check, 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 mate. Trap the king. Win material, just win the bishop. Mate in two. Win the bishop. Bishop C4 is the nail in the coffin. So this weakens E7, such that the later the queen's able to take E7. So check, try to trap the queen. We do kind of trap the queen, but kind of not. Free stuff. Okay. Right. There's the mate. We trap the king again, and then play queen f7. Here's again a standard mate in seven or six. I've lost count completely. Queen A3 is the fastest mate. This is a silly tactic that you won't have to ever worry about in your own games, but it's still cool for just the sake of acknowledging that it could potentially maybe happen in some fantasy variant of a game. I will destroy your wrists. Well, that's no good. Could be a lot worse, but yeah. 61. Who's this mate? Who's this mate? Alright. Just win a queen. It's not winning a queen, it's winning material. Oh. going on here? So if I move my knight, the bishop hangs. That's why I hesitate to play knight e7. Oh, it protects the bishop. Very clever. Okay. Free queen. Just have to not get mated. Check. And then win a queen. Okay. I have to play something. Here's a move. Ah, there's mate in one. Why win material when you can just checkmate? Check, check, mate. Does that not win the queen? Or do I need to do something better? Oh, that's slow at winning the queen. I get it. So I'd have to play bishop f7 to follow, which I thought surely was good enough. Okay. What gives? Queen f7 actually is not as crushing as it looks. It's not crushing at all. So just take the pawn, and somehow that wins. F2 is loose, so I should take D2, except taking D2 is not forcing. This is the only way, and then we win the rook at D2. That was clever. Oh, there's the mate. Okay. I've seen this one before, actually. On a previous level. Okay. Now what? Pin the queen. Win the queen? Oh, I have another piece. Smash you with all of my pieces. Okay, threatening mate. No big deal. It's just checkmate. Okay, do I just like win the queen? No. Do I take the bishop? Yeah. Oh, I get it. The bishop was a useful piece to interpose. How do I get the king to e5? If I could get that king to land on e5, I could win a queen. Maybe queen e6 mates. Maybe. I'm not sure about this. Great, I got the king over to h4. Just where we didn't need him. Oh, there it is. Okay, well, that was weird. But yeah. What kind of opponent's just gonna leave their king this exposed? Voluntarily. I just don't get it. Free queen? Actually, it's mate. Who needs queens when you can just take kings? Okay, here again the key is rook g2 so you don't get mated. Trap the queen, win the trapped queen. Check, 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 check and mate. Deflection or decoy. No, that was deflection. Okay, threaten mate. And then execute the threat. And then protect the bishop there. Trap the queen. I've never seen so many queen traps before. It's pretty ridiculous. I mean, other piece traps are fairly common, but this site loves the queen traps. I guess just because they're verifiable, like a human can understand, oh, that queen is trapped. Well, I've seen this puzzle before. It's just a forced mate. Nothing too instructive about that. And then rookie one. Okay, mate in one. It's not queen f7. There goes all my progress. What is it here? What's the answer? Oh, right, just take the free hanging thing that for whatever reason the opponent decided just wasn't worth defending. Okay, win the queen quickly and damage your opponent's pawn structure. As opposed to the move I found the first time, which also wins the queen pretty quickly and does not damage the pawn structure. It might cost an extra tempo, I wasn't really counting. Also, it seems like there aren't too many puzzles. Either I'm just getting better at recalling things quickly, or or there just aren't as many puzzles in each set. I think the deal is, though, that some of these puzzles have been used in so many levels that I just hammer out the solution to the ones that I recognize from previous levels. So I guess what I'm arguing is that I've actually learned some of these specific puzzles in the forms that they're presented on this site. So there's some really limited utility in that, and that you're not going to see these puzzles in an actual game. Like, the themes sure might crop up from time to time, but yeah. Alright, 62. I should just submit a level that has only one puzzle in it, and then solve it, and then I'll be at the top of the leaderboard ahead of Lance. Let's see. Don't remember the position, but it was bishop c4, e6, queen d8, bishop b4, check possible. No, there was a pawn on e7. So that was, in fact, winning a queen. Yeah. I kept missing that queen g5 idea. I eventually came around and found it. Either that or I just didn't see the puzzle again. I don't even remember. But on to level 62 we go. Free queen. Free. Oh, come on. Okay, fine, I'll checkmate him. I still think taking the queen is more demoralizing to the opponent than checkmate. So. Is that not mate? Is this not forcing a mate? How does e5 not trap the king? E5, king e2. I mean, it looks pretty good. Oh, right, my bishop's hanging. Ha. I see it now. Alright, so let's just back the bishop up. Oh, come on, really? Okay, so do I have to sack my queen for mate? No. I just have to checkmate. Where's the mate? Goodness. Is it like F4? No. Rook D1? I mean, wherever the mate is, it's not obvious. Bishop G6 forces mate pretty quickly. But apparently there's something better. Do I have to take this? Okay, no. Thank goodness. I'll say I'm not on board with that solution. It's gotta be one of these. Okay, but how is the king not escaping here? How is the. Oh, okay. It's mate in three. That's a little sticky. Trapped king. Alright. Winning a knight's not good enough. My initial reaction was knight to b5, but I rejected it because I didn't see where it was going. I guess it mates, so there's no need for me to reject it. Oh, this promotes on the spot. Usually you want your king close to the action there. Ha, stalemate. Alright, where's the checkmate here? Usually the thematic idea is king b c6, king b6, or intend king c7 somehow. There's got to be some way to trap this king. Alright, this isn't a bishop and a knight, so I can approach in that particular manner and be okay. Do I just take the queen and then take f7? Do I have better? Is this another silly trapped queen puzzle? Nope. Oh, this wins the knight. That's the key. I was gonna say, winning a pawn does not tend to satisfy this game. Okay, so h4 is loose, so I'm tempted to do knight h6 check. Maybe, oh, I just defend it and then take a free queen. Wow, these puzzles have stepped up in difficulty for sure. Just win the rook. Why do I do things the hard way? I don't know. Maybe just to make that more entertaining. Let's go with that. Okay, check. Check, check. I'll just threaten mate. Take the queen. And mate. Check. Draw the king out. Keep drawing it out. And mate. Trap the rook. Oh, free rook. Good enough. Mate. Free rook. It's not good enough because I've mate in one. I was happy with the free rook. Not gonna lie, I would have been happy with that free rook. Mate. Okay. Oh, just threaten mate. That's fun. And threaten it again. Do I have better? Yeah, that doesn't actually force mate, so I do need to have better. There we go. Found it. Free knight. Expose the king to win the rook. My mouse slipped. My bad. Force mate there. Rook f7. Queen f7. Oh, bishop c7 here. My bad. Again. Threaten mate. And then go for back rank mate instead. Win the queen. And then here it was this silly mate in 3. I'm not sure why you need to spot all that to get credit for the puzzle, but that's just how it works. Check. Yeah, we just build up a mating net. Mate in 1. Promote. Rook b8. Take the rook. Oh shoot, what was this one? I've forgotten. Bishop a6. Just building up the mating net. Right, in this one you're supposed to play knight b5, which just mystically, magically works out. Check. Oh, that would win a queen, except the king has nowhere to go, so we just mate instead. Protect h4, and then take the queen. H4 mates, somehow F4 does not. Somehow all the variations there if all the variations that weren't played do not mate. But this variation does mate. Let's check. Hey, look, I found an alternate solution. It's cool when these have more than one solution. As long as the alternate solutions are accepted. Mate in 2. Defend. Okay, win the knight. Take the knight, darn it. Mate in 2. Expose this king. Trap the king. Win a queen. Oh, right. You're never happy with me just taking a queen where I have a forced mate. Okay, knight b5. Let's mate. We force mate over here. We deflect the rook so you can promote. So bishop a6, just slowly building up. I'm not even sure that that qualifies as a tactic, but it's a blitz idea. But, semantics. Check, check, mate. Bishop a6. There's a mate. Here's a mate. That's a mate. Here we don't take the queen because we have mate in 1. Although I'm pretty sure taking the queen wins. Could be mistaken. But yeah, the checkmate's better. Though not much better. Alright. On to level 63. Yeah, the whole idea behind this site is that it repeats the puzzles over and over. instead of giving you new puzzles every time. That's just the site author's idea. There is some value to it because you do learn to recognize patterns. It's like a foreign language teacher program will not give you new words every single time, but it'll repeat some of the words. So, I guess that's the designer's idea. Anyhow, on to level 63. Mate? Not an instant mate. This wins the queen. And actually mates. Never mind. Mate and two. Knight of sevens also mate. Mate and four. That's not mate. Oh yeah, it is. Knight's pinned. It's a useful mate and four trick. I tend to just rely on that mate and four pattern rather than. Oops, that drops a rook. Okay. So what's the trick here? Check, check, mate. There we go. Yeah, if you find a pattern and it seems to work, it's okay if you don't play the mate that's the fewest number of moves. At least in a real game. On this site, it expects you to find the best mate. Which, really, for me, it just involves rote memorization, which is pretty silly and ridiculous. But, okay, so my queen's attacked, my rook's attacked, I could play knight takes rook. And we'd see queen takes rook, check. Could do knight e6 check, not really leading anywhere. Could do knight d7, rook takes, because if queen takes the rook, knight. If I do knight d7, queen takes knight, I could just take on b3 and be out material. I could promote with check. Bishop takes, rook takes, king g7, queen f. Oh, that looks good. Promote with check. Bishop takes, we do all that, and then king e7 instead, and then queen f6 is also mate. So this is the best continuation. There's a variation on it. So many variations on a theme. Okay. There's more than one way to do this. Ah. It's the right way to checkmate. Okay. Wow, that's really picky. These puzzles don't hold back. Free queen. Okay. Free queen. No, not. Well, there it is. Ah, bishop takes forces mate, too. Okay. What's the idea? C3 would defend my bishop and preserve my threat on G7. I have a feeling that there's something more here. Oh, I see. So this is a fork with rook e4. And the king moves, and I only get the bishop. I don't win a rook. Okay, well, this is confusing. Get it. You would think there'd be some obvious target. Okay, this pawn's pinned, so I've got knight f5. Knight f5, queen g6, knight check wins the queen. Okay. If you're spotting that in your blitz games, you should be playing for money. I'm just saying. Can make a buck or two that way. Why not King D7? Oh, I get it. So it's just trying to delay the mate, which is ridiculous. All right, so the obvious move's not best. That was cool. Mate in one. Yeah. Nice simple puzzle. You have to play Rook E1 here, because if Rook D1, Black plays Rook D6 and delays mate. Not sure why he blocks with the queen, knowing that this is going to happen next. Let's drag the king over to the A file. Mate in two. Mate in three. What was the idea here? I've completely forgotten this. Oh, this one's the queen. I was looking for a mate and not finding one. Yeah, knight of seven also mates. This is mate in one. This one's the queen. Actually, no, it doesn't. There's a knight on g1. So my whole motivation about winning a queen there was just completely wrong. And yet I still got the right answer, just for the wrong motivation. Decoy. Check, check, and mate. Okay. Check, check. Oh, there we go. I get it. Mate in one. Mate in X. Could even sack the queen first, as I did there. Win material, although we're not winning a rook, we're just winning a bishop. Just mate in one again. Mate in two. Another mate in two. And we're on to level 64. Alright, time to read up on what I've been missing. So what have you guys been saying? H8 equals knight, please. That would be funny. Rook takes queen, completely wrong. How long have I been doing these tactics? Well, yeah, some number of hours. If you estimate, say, 6 to 7 minutes per level, and see that I'm going into level 64, you can do the math and figure out it's been some hours. The earlier levels are pretty simple, but yeah, no, it's a fun site, so why not invest a little time doing it? Is bishop there trap a queen? No. Nope. Okay. I mean, my first thought was rook d8 check. And then followed up with like some sacks, like knight takes f7 and who knows. That was my first thought. Doesn't seem very plausible. Oh wait, do I have just rook ed3? Threatening rook d8 mate. King b8. Rook d8, king a7, bishop e3. Yeah, this has gotta be it. Okay. I'll just delay that checkmate. See where that gets you. Oh, come on! Knight takes d7 is beautiful. It's like a triple fork. It wins material, but yeah, checkmate's better. Oh, come on. Blitz tactics, you're killing me, man. Alright, so. Free rook. Free rook. But yeah, this is better. I expected to see a pretty obvious checkmate here. I'm not seeing it. Oh, there it is. Queen h6. Wow. Well, that's irregular. We have to get out of the pin. Okay, just win the queen. Easy peasy. Force mate somewhere. Oh, I get it. I get it. Tricky business, eh? F7's loose. No, because he gets rook F8 in that position. So, attack F7 this way, but he's still got rook F8. Gosh. What am I supposed to do? To quote one famous person, jeepers. No, I did not do all of this in one sitting. That would be pretty impressive. I don't know, I think this session's been going for a half hour or something so far. Maybe an hour, I don't know. Probably somewhere halfway in between. So, what's the deal? This is an interesting problem. Do I just take F7? Can we solve these tactics problems just by guessing every single time? Apparently not. Okay. That's a good. That's mean. That is like super ultra mean and funny. All right, so rook F5. And then mate. Easy. Once you know the answer. Free queen. Free queen again. And then once you're up two queens, just don't bother giving checkmate. Just have fun. Oh, yeah, taking the rook, I suppose, is good. That wins the bishop, or wins an exchange. Apparently, I've got better. Oh, I've got rook d8. And then I could take there. Mate. Not a mate. Not a mate. Not a mate. There's the mate. Okay. This one requires some precision. Just a bit. Holy moly, there's a kaleidoscope of candidate moves here, like bishop e5, or queen takes f8, or rook takes b8, or queen takes f7, or bishop e4. Not sure where to start. Oh, I get it. Queen takes f7 does force. Well, I mean, it forces mate, but apparently there's a better mate. Yeah, why not go for the simple checkmate? Why do things the hard way when you could do them the easy way? Okay, knight g5 is just a random guess, again, to avoid the cooldown timer. But it was wrong, so. Alright, so what do I do? All my pieces are on the queen side, minus this knight. I mean, it's one thing if the king's still on g8, I could probably just take c7. But that's not the case anymore. Discovered attack against the king. Wins the bishop. That's funny. That was the only weakness in black's position, was that exposed king. So I found a silly way to take advantage of that exposed king. Alright. Just promote. I'm not so big on these mating net things, in case you haven't gotten the gist by now. Because those mating patterns, they really aren't patterns. Like, checkmates tend to be pretty unique. So memorizing a particular checkmate, unless it's a pattern that crops up frequently, just isn't that valuable. All right, this one, that queen takes b8. It's not a mate, but that is a tactic that could potentially crop up in a game. All right, so I upped the stakes by taking on e8 first. Check, check. Smothered mate. Not your typical smothered mate, but it'll do. I wonder if you can invert the move order and take on c7 first. I'm gonna guess no. Oh, I'm guessing the intended solution is promote the pawn first, and although this happens to be equally good. I have to get out of check, get out of a pin, and deliver checkmate. What was this one again? I don't remember this at all. Ah, now I remember. Free rook, free queen. I forget the idea here. A rook to, or I was gonna say knight takes f7 wins a rook, except queen takes f7 kind of ruins that. Right, so we line up the pieces to deliver mate. Funny, there's no alternative sequence there. That's the only variation, at least as far as I can see. That's a fun mate in five, by the way. Yeah, I'm gonna guess queen. Oh, no, this is actually best. I needed to know, though. And now I do know. But that variation's the only variation. Beats me why he goes that way. I think any normal person, upon seeing that, upon seeing the idea of rook takes bishop check, would probably move the king to h7. Instead of moving the king as it did to, I'm sorry, to a7 instead of to a8. Just seems unrealistic that a player would willingly walk into a check. and one that has a forcing mate continuation. But maybe somebody would do that. Okay, so increase the stakes first and then take the queen. Because otherwise, you're just winning a rook for a bishop or something like that there. So you have to increase the stakes in that battle first. Forced mate. Queen to b1. Can I go on to the next level yet? Pretty please. There we go. 64 levels completed. Let's go up to level 65. Note, this does obtain me a score of 65 on the leaderboard, even though I have not started level 65 yet. There's an off by one bug in the scoreboard. But we're going to complete level 65 anyway, because we like tactics. We understand that? Good. Let's do this. Is this force mate? Yeah, that's pretty fun. Is this force mate? Oh, I should take the rook? No. Oh, I've got rook e1. There's the force mate. Check. Okay. Black continues playing on. Oh my goodness. Why would black continue playing on? Why continue the pain? At some point, you gotta learn how to concede, you know? If you lose half your army and your other half is, like, running away, conceding is a reasonable option at that point. But no, these puzzles want you to play it out to the end. So does c7 work? No. I wish. c7 work here? I mean, c7 totally promotes. But apparently there's a mate here somewhere. Okay. I'm just seeing queen c3 and thinking, gosh, how am I supposed to checkmate? Before that queen c3 can happen. Oh, I get it. I missed bishop e4. Okay. So what? What do I do? What do I do? I mean, I could do rook e5, force a rook trade, and be completely winning the endgame. Looks reasonable to me. Apparently, there's something better. What a ridiculous problem. Knight e6, g5, rook g7. Oh! Well, yeah. No, obviously that's right. But, okay, knight e4, for some reason. Oh, threatens mate in 1. Then we threaten mate in 1 again. And then we mate in 1. Okay. Great. That was really instructive. I learned a lot from it. Oh, the tactics are fun, so what can you do? I just want there to be some discovery where I win the queen. Can we just. I need to make a puzzle or a level where you get to do that discovery. Check. Check. Okay. This wins the rook. No, really, it wins the rook. Black should not be trading rooks there if he wants to make any attempt at winning or not losing. Oh, just completely threw me off that black dodged the mate, that I was unwilling to take the queen. Yeah, my thought was, of course he'll move the queen. And when he didn't, I just flipped out. I'm like, what's going on here? So, okay, bishop to b3 is not the answer, no matter how many times I make the move. Suppose I do need to use all my pieces. Alright, does this mate? Nope. Does queen b1 mate? Probably. I mean, I'm never going to see that in any of my games, so I don't feel too motivated to study it out. It's just guesswork if it's all checkmates. Yep, that's mate in two. Free rook. Is free rook not best? Why get a free rook when you can get a free king? I castle. I defy the laws of chess and castle anyway. Okay. Just win the queen. Win the queen. Fun stuff. Oh, really? Okay, I guess that mates. So, what I found was second best, because there was actually better continuation. Knight e4 threatens mate on the spot. Rook d1. Oh, there's a mate. So this, that may actually require some technique. Here you just win the queen. Hang on, check with that rook. Deflect the king over there. Mate in three. In the rook. For realsies, that's a one rook. Oops, bishop a7's the mate. Here he just hangs his queen, so you have to take it. Okay, I didn't see this the second time. I saw it the first time. Somehow queen b1 is right. Somehow. Again, I'm not overly inclined to understand mating problems because the odds of seeing the exact same thing or anything even remotely like it in one of my games is, tends to be pretty low. There are some standard checkmate motifs, but most of them don't involve, hey, look, all my opponent's pieces are hanging, I should just take them, sorts of mates. Now, why is that wrong? Oh, I guess king c6. We have to stop king c6. trying to play queen e8 there. If queen e8 were legal, it would be checkmate. But in that position, it's not legal. I'm always ready to play bishop g6 in that position, and always forgetting that the computer will. I'm forgetting the in-between move word. It'll always interrupt with an in-between move. I guess queen b1 is essential as the first move, because otherwise the king escapes. Okay, rook e6, f1, g6, put the king in a light square. If the king goes to h1, you have bishop e4. Free queen. It'd be funny if it varied up the answers on you. Like, if occasionally the defender wouldn't play queen f8, but would just take your rook. And you'd still have to find the right move. Bishop a7 is correct. Rook e8. Check, check, check. Mate. Check, check. Check, 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 mate, check, 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 and mate, check, get this puzzle again, get the sense that I've completed this level, but I'm not getting the next level message because there is no next level. But I get the sense that I've mastered this one. That's pretty funny. So yeah, I guess we're doomed to solve this puzzle set for all eternity. I suppose there are worse fates that a person could suffer. Oops, there it is. But yeah, we're stuck here for all eternity, just solving level 65. So, sorry we're stuck here, guys. Not my fault. Don't blame me. I'm just the player. Okay. That was fun. Alright. So, yeah, I think I've completed Blitz Tactics. Very cool. I could refresh the leaderboard, but we see I've already got 65, so yay B. Hope everybody enjoyed this. I need something to cool down after that. That was pretty intense. Let's see. Yeah, so again, if you guys want to try this, I guess. I don't know if you would, but yeah, the site is blitztactics.com. In my mind, this is still in beta for at least a couple reasons. One, the bugs that I came up across are things that I complained about during these sessions. And two, the creator hasn't open sourced the project yet, and he keeps saying he's going to do it. I don't believe him. Some people are perfectionists, and I think that this person, while they are perfectionists, they're just overwhelmed doing the project by themselves. But at the same time, they're too embarrassed by their code to release it. I'm guessing that that's probably the case, but what do I know? In any event, this hasn't been open sourced yet, so I'm saying it's still in beta. They did add a new feature recently where it keeps track of your best level times. I honestly couldn't be bothered with that. As long as I solve each level, I don't really care about what my best time is. So, yeah, I have defeated blitztactics.com, and we've all enjoyed this together. So yeah, I'll take a break and come back with something a bit lighter. So thanks for watching. Hope you guys have fun watching the chess event coverage from abroad. And hope to see you guys next time.